Chris Boy, más conocido como Paper Ghost, es uno de los mayores expertos en seguridad de Internet a nivel mundial. En su visita reciente a Madrid, de la mano de la compañía DotForce, nos habló de los temas más candentes en relación al spyware y al hacking. ¿Cuáles son los ataques de spyware más comunes?
The most common spyware attacks at the moment aren't so much exploit code and things like that. It's actually social engineering, cheap parlor tricks, and in short, coming up with ways that the bad guys can con the end user into downloading an application, installing it, and having it run on the desktop.
¿Incrementa los dispositivos móviles los riesgos para la seguridad?
Mobile devices such as PDAs, mobile phones, Blackberries, as all of these devices become more interconnected and more interdependent on each other, so too does the security threat increase.
En su opinión, ¿quiénes están más expuestos a los ataques de spyware? ¿Los usuarios individuales o los de empresa?
Okay. The spyware threat doesn't really differentiate between home users and business users with regards who's being attacked. They treat everyone the same. They'll attack you just the same. And if you're an instant messaging user, the key advice is always to be alert and make sure that the link that you send is actually from the person that you think it was sent from.
¿Qué tres consejos daría usted a los usuarios para evitar el spyware?
Three ways to avoid spyware attacks. Number one, try running a limited account. This will restrict the amount of things that can install on the PC and hopefully protect you from a spyware attack. Number two is to treat everything the same. Be it email communication, instant messaging, be wary of them all, and hopefully you won't get hit with something unpleasant. And number three, nothing is ever quite what it seems in the world of spyware, so always be on your guard.
Como usuario de mensajería instantánea, ¿qué debería hacer para evitar los ataques de spyware?
Instant messaging is a major cause for concern in the field of security nowadays. Hackers are turning away from the standard web page drive-by in favour of cruder forms of attack, which gives a bigger payoff, such as instant messaging. Everybody on your instant messaging list, you know them, you trust them. So if you see a link come through from somebody on your contact list one day, are you going to think twice or are you going to click it? You're going to click it, and when you do, you're probably going to get hit with some spyware, some adware. If your friend's been infected, there's a good chance they may well infect you as well if you're not paying attention.